long broad trunk, amply provided with back, and a head with enormous protruding and shining eyes. On the back of this huge planetary body layers are two large wings, and on the underside two comparatively small feet with very strong claws. Almost the entire strength of this huge planetary body is adapted by nature to generate energy for their eyes and their wings. As a result, the three-brained beings breathing on that planet are basically everywhere. However greatly, KL-E, asterisk it can move about not only on the planet but also in its atmosphere, and occasionally some of them even manage to travel beyond its limits. On another planet not far from the planet Mars, beings are covered in a soft, woolly outer form of these three-centered beings is like that of a tunica, that is, it resembles a kind of double sphere, the upper sphere serving to contain the principal organs of the planetary body, and the lower one the organs for the transformation of the first and second being tools. In the upper sphere there are three apertures opening outward, the lower sphere has only two apertures, one in front of the taking in of the first and second being tubes, and the other is the back for the elimination of residue from the organism and the lower sphere are attached to strong sinewy feet, and on each of these it is protuberance that serves the same purpose as our fingers. That's on means darkness. There is still another planet in that solar system, my dear boy, quite a small one, bearing the name Moon. During its movement, this peculiar little planet often came very near our planet Mars, and sometimes for whole sopranos I took great pleasure in observing, through this testuano, in my observatory, the process of existence of the three-brained beings who inhabit it. Though the beings of this planet have very frail planetary bodies, they have an indomitable spirit, which gives them an extraordinary perseverance and capacity for work. Their external form is like that of large ants, and like them they are always bustling about, working both on and within their planet. The results of their ceaseless activity are already plainly visible. I once happened to notice that in two of our ears they had tunneled the whole of their planet. They were obliged to undertake this task on account of the abnormal climatic conditions there, caused by the fact that this planet arose unexpectedly, and therefore the regulation of its climatic harmony had not been prearranged by the higher powers. The climate of this planet is truly mad, and in its variability from weak points to the most high strong, the spherical lumen existing on another planet of that solar system, which I shall also tell you about. Sometimes the cold is so intense on this moon that everything is frozen through and through, and it becomes impossible for beings to breathe in the open atmosphere, and then suddenly it gets so hot that you could fry an egg in a jiffy. There are only two short periods on that peculiar little planet, namely, before and after it completes its orbit around a neighboring planet, when the weather is so glorious that Testuano means telescope. For several rotations the whole planet is in the moon, and yields the various products for the first being cool of its inhabitants, even greatly in excess of what they need for existence in that strange intraplanetary kingdom they have survived, where they are sheltered from the vagaries of this mad climate and all the inharmonious changes in the state than ours. Moreover, they have no tails, and their heads are without horns. But the worst thing about them is when they meet, for they have no roots. It is true that for protection against external influences, they have invented what they call food. But this invention does not do them much good. Aside from the imperfection of their external form, their reason is uniquely and utterly bizarre. There, being reason, owing to many causes that I may tell you about sometime,